There's a lily, it's in the valley. Count it to be bright as the morning star. There's a lily, Lord.
What's going on, everybody? This is Pastor B with Tuesday's Touch for May the 11th, and we have been reading through and praying through the book of Acts. We last left off with the disciples asking Jesus if now was the time that the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, would be restored to Israel. Would now God come and elevate the nation of Israel back to its former place of glory? Jesus replies to them by saying, it's not for you to know what God is about to do. In other words, leave God's timing to God. You just make sure that you are my witnesses in Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria to the uttermost parts of the world. And you won't have to be my witnesses alone, because the Holy Spirit is going to come upon you and give you power. That's what we talked about last week. The challenge now, however, is that they started out with 12 disciples, but now they only have 11. And they feel like the work that they are doing is so important that they need a full 12. They probably also want 12 because there were 12 tribes of Israel, and for them, numbers were symbolic and powerful. If you can remember, Judas, who betrayed Jesus, was so guilty for the crime he committed, betraying an innocent man, that he committed suicide and killed himself. And so now the 12 are 11, and they feel like they need to add somebody. And they use two criteria for selecting a new partner for their ministry. The first criteria is to look at the person's history. We see this in verse 21 of chapter number 1 of Acts. Therefore, it is necessary to choose one of the men who have been with us the whole time the Lord Jesus was living among us. And so they say, we need to pick somebody who their history says has been with us, who we can look into their past and see that they have been with us and they've bought into who we are and what we're about. Then we see the second criteria starting at verse number 24 of that same chapter. Then they prayed, Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which of these two you have chosen to take over the apostolic ministry, which Judas left to go where he belongs. So after they applied the first criteria, two names came to the surface, one man by the name of Barsabbas and another man by the name of Matthias. And after they applied their first criteria of looking at the person's history, their track record, have they been with us, then they applied the second criteria, which was to pray to God. And then God lifted to their spirits the person by the name of Matthias, and Matthias completed the number 12. So now, what criteria do you use to determine your friendships? What criteria do you use to determine who you allow into the personal spaces of your life? What criteria do you use to determine what type of business partners you'll have? What criteria do you use to determine how you will have a love relationship, or whether you'll have a loving relationship with someone? What criteria do you use? I think you ought to use some criteria. Now, understand that if you use criteria to determine who you allow in your space, you're not judging them as bad people. What you're saying is that God is taking me this way, and based on the criteria or my assessment of this person, they're not going to help me get this way, so I'm not going to allow them into my personal space. God's trying to take my business to X location, and based on this person's practices in the past, they're not going to be able to help me, I don't think, get to where I'm going, so I'm not going to include them. When you use criteria to make assessments about where people should be in your life, you're not judging them as bad. Instead, you're guarding God's purposes and God's plans and God's promises for your life. And I don't know about you, but God's purposes, God's plan, and promises in my life are so important to me that I guard them so that just anybody can't get in and potentially disrupt them. So you should have some criteria as to how you determine who will be in your personal space, in your personal life, in your business life, and in your love life. And if you're wondering about some good criteria, start off with the criteria they use. Number one, has this person been with me? What does their history say about them? And number two, pray. what does God say about them? If you use that criteria, I'm pretty sure that if you listen to what God says as a result of it, you'll get it right every time. This is Pastor B with Tuesday's Touch for May the 11th. Hey, listen, I want to tell you, number one, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers. God bless you. Love you. And also, if you are a person that uses our website for information, for your tithing offering, for your giving, for whatever, notice I want you to be aware that in a couple of days, probably by the end of the week, the website will look differently, but it is still St. James. You can go under there. You'll see me. You'll see the other staff members. You'll see the elders. You'll see images of our worship on the lawn. So the website's going to change a little bit, but it is still St. James. You can go there, find scripture reading guides, find pathways to discipleship, all the details about us. Also, you can watch services. You can see Tuesday's Touch. Hey, it's the same site. It just looks a little different, a little more user-friendly for everybody to enjoy. This is Pastor B with Tuesday's Touch. God bless you and God keep you. You have been touched.
There's a lily garden, it's in the valley. Found it to be bright as the morning star. There's a lily garden.